Hi everybody, you are watching ReclaiMe Data Recovery channel, and today I want to talk about how to recover data from QNAP devices. QNAP devices now are very popular both among home users and small organizations. So first, a couple of words about the device and how it stores the data. There are several disks inside the QNAP. Mine has 6 disks, but they can be diverse with 2, 3, 4 or even 12 disks. Disks in QNAP are combined into single storage using RAID technology. QNAP devices support different RAID levels, but typically RAID 5, RAID 6 or RAID 10 are used because they are fault tolerant. Two-bay QNAP devices create mirror configuration because it is fault tolerant too. As far as file system goes, QNAP devices have been using ext file system for years. Often people search for QNAP data recovery solution if one of the remember disks fails. Theoretically, you need to replace the failed one and everything should work fine. However, once in a while something goes wrong during the rebuild, resulting in data loss. Another situation involving data loss is when QNAP partitions turn to raw due to file system metadata damage. Well, to recover data from QNAP, you need QNAP disks, a computer you are going to connect the QNAP disks to, and the new blank disks, which you will use to copy the recovered data to. Disconnection is an additional pain. The simplest case involving 2-bay QNAP devices requires maximum of 4 ports on the motherboard. 2 ports are for the source drives and other 2 ports are for copying the data. Modern motherboards have at least 4 ports, usually 5. But what to do if you have a 6-bay QNAP device like mine? Here you have several options. Take the disk of large capacity. For example, I have a 6-bay QNAP NAS equipped with 2 terabyte disks. As far as I know, there is about 6 terabytes of data stored on it. So I can get one large disk of 8 terabytes to copy the recovered data to. The second option is to use host bus adapter, allowing to connect more disks to a PC. For example, I have LSI adapter and adaptic fanout cable, which working together give me 4 additional SATA connections. If you are absolutely sure that the failure was not caused by the QNAP, you can use the very same QNAP to copy the recovered data. Besides, I think that most people at the end of the recovery want to get the working configuration as it was before the data loss, that is, the data stored on a single NAS storage. If you are going to use your QNAP to copy the recovered data, the first thing you should do is to set it up. So you need to put the disks into the QNAP, choose the configuration and connect the QNAP to your network. Since it is a broad topic, I can shoot another video if you are interested. But if you suspect that something is wrong with the QNAP box, do not use it. One more note, if you lack, say, only one free port on the motherboard, consider using USB to SATA cable. But remember that USB connection is not stable. So we have discussed all the preparations except last but not least NAS recovery software. There are few tools, including our ReclaiMe File Recovery, which are capable of recovering data from broken NAS devices. And predictably, we will use our software. So let's proceed with the recovery process. Here is my QNAP with a failed disk and incomplete rebuild. Here is a disk I'm going to recover data to. And here is my computer. As you can see, this is not a typical PC, but some kind of workstation. There are all PC components, but not inside the box. This is power supply unit, motherboard. As you can see, there are 5 ports, but I need to connect 7 disks, so I use LSI adapter. Well, pull the disks out of the QNAP. Label them. to be aware of the correct disk order if something goes wrong. Now we need to connect disks to EPC. Connect SATA and power. PC. Go to the ReclaiMe site www.reclaimme.com. Download and install the software. Once disk scanning is finished, you are able to see your QNAP disks and partitions in the available devices list. This is a typical picture of QNAP partitions having names, claim, swap, and so on. I select the largest partition and click Start. Now ReclaiMe starts analyzing file system metadata on the partition, and in a short time we see the recovered folders and files. Check the quality of the recovery by previewing files, preferably images. If they are correct, all other files are most likely correct as well. The software lets you copy the files once immediately before the end of scanning. We suggest watching the number of files indicator, and once it stops growing, pause the recovery and copy the data. To copy the data, you need to purchase an ultimate license key. Now we are done. If you like our videos, subscribe to the ReclaiMe channel. ReclaiMe team was with you. See you soon!